Okay, I feel very honored to be invited to share. This is a journey not about myself. It's a journey about cancer survivors, new patients. And I also think that it's a journey that goes beyond cancer survivors. Like what Michael shared just now, heart patients, stroke patients. So this is really a journey about recovery, embracing the change, and moving forward, finding purpose in life, and always believe that there's hope, and we live with that belief. So hope is always the rainbow. So I love this picture very much. And of course, tell myself, the journey is tough, but never tough if it's really mind over body, and you're not doing it alone. You have your loved ones, your caregivers, your families, relatives, and even your friends, right? In fact, today I have a lot of my friends here supporting me. My sister is also here supporting me. I also have two committee members here supporting me. Thank you very much. Okay, a bit of my history. Okay, since I was diagnosed 12 years ago, it was in a very dark tunnel, okay? But I knew that at the end of the tunnel, I would see this light. Because I'm also very blessed because I'm born positive, a positive person. I always look beyond, and that helped me a lot. Okay, I started with a very long-term cough, you know, about a year. Just dry cough, itchy throat, a cough. Sometimes a bit of blood came out, okay? And then I went to see GPs, my own family doctor, my company doctor. At the time, my company had two doctors. I went to see all of them. But all of them dismissed me as, maybe your sensitive throat, send me for x-ray. Everything looked fine. You know, those days I was running a marathon, maybe. So they said, you look so good, so maybe just a bit of a sensitive throat. So they dismissed me. Actually, today I can still go back and sue them. But no, I'm a nice guy, so I'm not going to do that. So in August 2002, it was a night of thunder and storm. So we call 风雨交加 in Chinese. And the wind crossed with the rain. Okay, in those old drama, Cantonese drama, when there's a night like this, something happened. But not that something happened to me. Okay, what happened to me was my nose started to bleed, and it was on the right side. I was about to sleep. This is a picture of the nasal pharynx. Nasal pharynx is actually a tube which connects our nose to the throat. Okay. Then I went to see a specialist the following week, and a 2 cm tumor was detected right in the middle here. Okay. Luckily, it was localized. It was a stage 2A. And first question the doctor asked me was, are you a Cantonese? Of course, I'm very proud to be a Cantonese. I said, yes, I'm a pure Cantonese. I said, what does being a Cantonese do with this cancer? This likely cancer. He said, a lot of people from Hong Kong and Guangzhou have this type of cancer. So then he told me, he said, could be your genes, being a Cantonese, could be the salted fish you eat. You know, Cantonese like eat salted fish. The wax duck, wax meat, you know, lap cheong, you know, all kinds of things. But I said, being a Singaporean, I also eat a lot of roti prata and, you know, So it's just too complex. Anyway, because this nose cancer is largely a Asian type cancer, and the Asian type cancer is mostly in Chinese, and among the Chinese, even in NUH, the statistic is that more Cantonese than other dialect. So because of this is a largely Asian disease, so it's not very well researched, I was told. So there's no statistics to show that. Because of the soup we drink. Maybe it's the soup I drink. I drink a lot of Cantonese soup. Every week also got soup one. I love the soup. Anyway, so it's too complex. So biopsy diagnosis confirmed is stage 2A. And I went through a 6-week radiotherapy treatment. Radiotherapy is like x-ray, okay? But the intensity is 1,000 times stronger than the x-ray. Imagine you go for x-ray every day. It's a no-no, right? So this is an x-ray 1,000 times, the normal x-ray, and it's every day, And I signed up for a guinea pig program. Okay? Although I don't look like a guinea pig, but... because the doctor told me that in Germany, they tested it, and they did it twice dosage a day, and it works very well. So I was the first patient in Singapore to go through this treatment. And maybe thanks to the doctor, because of this treatment, I'm still here today sharing with you. So the last 3 weeks, I went through twice a day radiation. So what happened to me during the RT session, I had a lot of heat on my skin. Okay, later you'll see the photos before and after, how I changed. Then I also felt very tired, but just could not rest, you know. Now I'm looking at the timer. I was lying there, I couldn't sleep. The heat and the pain, I was looking at the clock, and the clock was just ticking second by second. I was living life that way, you know. You know, just don't know what to do, you know. And I have a lot of ulcers inside my mouth, and the ulcers were bleeding with blood. So it's like a dagger in my throat. You know, the pain is just beyond words, lah, you know. So this could be the side effect, because I went through twice a day. But of course, today when I confront my oncologist, he still denied that is the side effect due to the twice a day radiation. Then breathing through my mouth was really painful. That's why I couldn't sleep at night, because at night I breathe through my mouth. So when I couldn't sleep, it made my life even more difficult to pass day by day, you know. Then my wife introduced the aromatherapy, okay? That's why I love lavender. Now everything is lavender. Tea, lavender, soap, lavender, shampoo, also lavender. Conditioner, also lavender. Because lavender was the first fragrance to really cool me, subsided my pain. Then I could sleep. Once I could sleep at night, my recovery was much faster. And because it's so pain to cough and sneeze, I had to hit my head on the wall to distract the pain, okay? I just have to kneel down and then hit hard so that I don't feel the pain so much. Because the ulcers in the mouth is really, really bad. And because I couldn't eat, right, it's so painful, I couldn't even drink. But, and then the doctor actually advised me to be hospitalized, go on drip. But of course I refused. I want to go home and see my family, you know? So now I'm phobia with this milk. You know, I got to gulp this milk 4 packets a day. And actually very expensive. 1 milk at the time cost $6 per pack. But it's not the cost. It's really very painful. So that split second, the couple of seconds to drink down this milk, was the painful moment of my few seconds of my life, really. Then, you know. So then I really think back and said, for all my life, for 38 years, I have even been drinking for granted, you know. It was so difficult to drink. Support from families and friends, of course, I have a lot of support from my loved ones, you know, my wife, my kids. And actually, I'm very blessed because I have these two beautiful twins, okay, one girl, one boy. And I'm very blessed. So when the cancer hit me, they were about 2-3 years old. I told myself they were my pillars. Okay, that's why I need to come home every day and see them. And they actually pushes me on. Of course, my son come home, he said, Daddy, you look like a monster. But my daughter still come and hug me. So until today, my daughter is closer to me than my son. Then my family, they are like, this one 2 years ago, was taken 2 years ago. Of course, my extended family. Okay, that's how I looked like before. Okay, a bit chubby here. And now I want to put on weight, also very difficult. According to the doctors and oncologists, say that here I can never put on weight because this cell somehow is already a bit damaged. So I mean, those days I was under the obese range. Now I'm under the perfect weight. Okay, I have. Is this a bit bloody here? Yeah, I was bleeding and I had also pus flowing down from my face and my neck. That's why my son said I look like a monster. True enough, really look like a monster. In fact, I lost 15 kg, alright? And after my treatment, after I recovered a wee bit, I went back to work. Some of my colleagues said, are you a new colleague joining the company? So I also couldn't recognize myself. But actually, this weight now is good because I couldn't gain back to this weight, which is good news because now it's my ideal weight. The side effects are, okay, the side effects of cancer treatment. Okay, the thing about cancer is that the treatment is very straightforward, whether is it RT, chemo, surgery or combination. But the thing about chemo is that you have side effects then. It's transitional. So chemo is not too bad. But for the long term, it's really the radiotherapy. So radiotherapy will give you long-term side effect. Now, even after 12 years, I'm experiencing a side effect. I don't know what will happen tomorrow. Okay? So it's always living life to the fullest every day. Okay? So I have my salivary gland damaged because of the ray. So, you know, we have about 4 salivary glands, the 2 big ones left and right, and then the 2 smaller ones beneath the tongue. I only have these 2 smaller ones beneath the tongue surviving. The left and right, the big ones are all dead, permanent. Okay? So I have very little saliva now, and I always carry a bottle of water with me when I speak, or I use artificial saliva. Okay? My sense of smell and all this also dropped by about 10-20%. Alright? So sometimes at home, I speak a bit louder because I can't hear myself. Then my family members thought that I'm shouting. But over these years, they have more or less got used to me. Okay, in time to come, the face and mouth muscle may also be hardened. So I was told to exercise my mouth every day, every morning, and every evening before I sleep, and as and when I can, because this exercising of the muscles is good for me, because that will kind of like make it, the hardened process is just to delay the process from coming sooner, right? Trismus is a medical term. The teeth also become brittle because of the rays. Because when you go through radiotherapy, no doctors on earth can guarantee that the rays will not go elsewhere. So even though they try to make the ray very precise, but you'll still hit some of your parts that are not supposed to hit in your body, around the ENT area. So the teeth also become brittle because it was also affected by the ray. So maybe tomorrow I may lose all my teeth. I don't know when. All right. So this thing will come one day. Right, the foot tube muscle may also harden. Now, so if this happens, means that I cannot eat and swallow like normal, right? So now, whatever food I can enjoy, I better enjoy more because I don't know when this will come. Because in time to come, if this really happened to me, they will have to punch a hole here and then put a foot tube where I take liquid food. My voice will change. You know, I like to sing. So I will want to sing like, you know, tomorrow now, if I have a chance to sing karaoke. The reason is because I may lose my voice in time to come. And I've witnessed some of the people like going into their 16-year, 23rd year, you know, 2 of the survivors I met, they actually lost their voice. Overnight, their voice just became very hoarse and the voice never recovered. Okay, so these are again the side effects of radiation. Pain in the neck. I'm not a pain in the neck, but I have pain in the neck. Okay, the pain in the neck is because of the nerve. Okay, somehow the nerves will get affected. So this pain will come like once in a while when I go for a long run, you know, sometimes I come back, I have a pain. But that is still bearable. And my sinus, I never have sinus, but I got this sinus problem. In fact, recently I got a, they found a tunnel. They found a small little tunnel, not MRT tunnel, but a tunnel between my mouth to my sinus. You know, sinus are those open spaces in the nose for ventilation purpose. So my mouth, they found this tunnel. They said, don't know where this tunnel come from. Then they said, could be this, could be that. Then they zoom into probably the radiation. So they had to extract one of my tooth up here and then cut some flesh from my chin inside the mouth and patch up the tunnel. And after all this operation, after I couldn't open my mouth for about 4 weeks, the surgery failed because I still have water coming up from my nose because it's not an easy surgery. So I just have to embrace these changes and cope with it, okay, as survivors, all right? So because of this sinus, you also give me a lot of bad breath, okay? And my ear wax, because the ear has the mechanism to remove all the wax. You know, this is a very natural bodily process, but this process is spoiled. So my earwax, I can't do it myself, and they get hardened very fast, so I need to see a doctor to clear my earwax. So anyway, all these are just something I experienced. But everybody is different. The side effects will come different and different time. Okay? So we just have to manage it accordingly. And really, this change is something that we cannot avoid, we cannot prevent. We can try to prolong it. Right? Most important is we have to embrace it, face it head on, and accept it positively. Right? That is really the mindset change. It's not easy, but we all have to try, you know, as survivors, as patients. And of course, always believe that there's always light at the end of a very dark tunnel. And of course, the beautiful rainbow, right? Hope is everywhere. Statistically, cancer and some of the illness and diseases that come to us, many of them are related to our immune system. Okay, of course, genetic factor is one, right? But most of them are immune system. That means something that we can control, all right? So here, I want to share with you all, after I struck with cancer, I did a lot of research, I talked to dietitians, doctors, and I actually so-called invented my own superb breakfast, right? I'm going to share with you in a while what is this superb breakfast. But I'll share with you first, the immune system is very important. So moving forward, how we can control our life, okay, how we can face this head-on and really want to look beyond is really to boost our immune system. This is something we all can do. I'm no Superman, okay? You know, Yvonne, who is my committee member, she's no Wonder Woman. How we can do it? It's just because we believe in doing it, believe in ourselves, and really, you know, just believe in ourselves that we can do it. Now, how to boost the immune system? Of course, food very important. Eat healthily, right? This is one of my best food, sweet potato, right? Sweet potato is the best food to build to boost your immune system. Of course, exercise. I run, I swim a lot. I manage your stress. Stress is a silent killer, as we all know, right? At work, even family. So we have to find a way to balance it. And the way to balance it is really find a way to manage your stress. Listen to music. Or for ladies, go shopping also can. Go traveling, whatever you want to do. Just find a way to discharge yourself. That's very important, right? Because we are no robots, we are humans. So we need to manage our stress. And of course, rest well. Okay, every day, 8 hours, 7 hours of sleep, very important. And of course, cut down on smoking. If you smoke or drink a lot, cut all this. My dad, actually my family has a history of colon cancer. My father, my grandmother, my father's sister, all died of colon cancer. That's why when I see the doctor, I ask the doctor, how come not colon? How come from colon run up to the nose? In fact, nose cancer is not known to be hereditary. Okay, but now, that's why my whole family is now under a study to see how come, you know, from behind here run up to up here. Because my younger brother also passed away of nose cancer. My younger brother is 2 years younger than me. He had nose cancer 2 years ahead of me. But he passed away in the fifth year. The second relapse, he passed away. Right? So I learned this from my late father, and of course my mother too. I'm a Cantonese, so this is a Cantonese character. Tin tit lok le, tong pei kam. Okay, what it means is when the sky falls, treat it as a blanket, you know. Of course, not to sleep, but you see, you look at this, it seems to be very pessimistic. But the way I look at it as a survivor, positively, is that the blanket keep us warm, right? So you face it head on, courageously, you know, because if it comes, it comes. Nobody can hide the facts, right? Yes, we can cry, you know, whatever, but end of the day, we still have to face reality, right? So, and maybe from that, it's a sort of opportunity. You know, to be frank, this last 12 years, I think I'm a better person because I started to appreciate things, small little things. I cherish my loved ones, my families, people around me, you know. And I help out in the support group. I help out in the school. So it's my little way to give back. And I really think that I no longer the selfish me that I used to be once upon a time. Why? Because, so I want to thank cancer actually. Cancer made me a better person. So in a way, it's an opportunity to change, to convert that so-called the bad fate you have, the bad fate I have, the bad destiny into something positive. Right? So that's how you look at it from another perspective. And of course, living life to the fullest every day, being positive. It's not easy, but We all must try, right? So the spirit of trying, he never died, right, to me. Okay, now I share my breakfast. So this is my simple breakfast. You know, I've been taking this every day for 12 years, believe it or not. That's why my wife said, it's so boring. It can go on like this every day. I guess for me and for people like us that walk through a different path in life, it's very difficult to put it in words, you know. But to me, I fell in love with sweet potato even before I had cancer. So when I take sweet potato as breakfast every day, to me, it's a natural thing. In fact, if I don't take, I feel addicted. I feel shaky. The withdrawal syndrome. You know, and sweet potato is really good. And take with the skin, because the skin has very high fiber content. Okay? See, so beautiful, right? The tomatoes, right? Sweet potato, tomatoes, all these bright color fruits, you know, they have very high antioxidant content. This antioxidant is known to prevent free radicals to fight those bad things in your body, right? And boost your army in your body, right? As I said, our immune system is one of the best doctors on earth in our body. We all have it, so let's cherish it, protect it, and give it a boost every morning if you can. Okay, and of course, these are the good things in the fruits. Okay? Actually, besides this, you also can take juice and all this. Oh, these are also good. And those bright color vegetables like capsicums. In fact, chili is also good. But of course, nobody eats chili like this. Capsicums and bright vegetables. Okay, these are very good food to boost our immune system. After taking this for 12 years, in fact, the first 2 years, I feel the effect. I used to fall sick like every 3-4 months. Flu, cold. After taking this diet, this thing never happened to me. You know? And I really feel that I can still climb the mountain and look for the tigers, although I'll not kill the tigers. Right. I feel stronger after taking this diet. So of course, these are the... Okay, some of the no-no food that I take are these, just to share with you quickly. Barbecue meat, because meat, once you're under direct fire, the meat will mutate. Right? When you take into your body, especially all these burnt parts. Okay, I got nothing against... Mei Zhen Xiang, okay? I've got nothing against the satay man, no? These are very nice food. But I'm just sharing it with you that these are the food I really stop now completely because, in fact, all my life I never liked this food. I take it once in a while, like bak kwan, like once a year, but now I completely don't take because these are really bad food. Carcinogens go into your body, it may or may not develop into cancer. So we can cut this chance of having it develop into cancer, why not, you know? Okay, I need to do this exercise because, as I told you just now, to prevent my mouth muscle from hardening, because if the mouth muscle hardens, means I cannot open my mouth, I cannot eat. My brother, before he passed away, his mouth was like this. Like this. Like this. Because the muscle all hardened. His neck couldn't move. He got to move like that, his whole body, to see. Because his neck was hardened. Why? Because my brother was very stubborn. Okay, he was just unlike me. He didn't want to exercise, want to do all this, you know, even though I nagged at him. So, you see, you will get the consequences if you don't work hard. You just have to work hard, have to religiously tell yourself to do something about your own health, your own body moving forward. So, survivors, as I said, we must always embrace the change positively. So, morning greeting and smile to me is very important. Okay, exercise regularly. I do this every Sunday night. And then these are my makeup kit. You know, I use all this gel and all this at night and the daytime. So now as I speak, I got artificial saliva inside my mouth so that it won't keep my mouth moist. And this is for my nose. Okay, so you just have to manage it, your time, you know. And really, I think time is 24 hours. Everybody has 24 hours per day. But how do we manage it? Is really prioritize it. So, you know, can be done. The previous speaker shared that, you know, be thankful, Dr. Tan just now, right? Every morning wake up, be thankful, be grateful, you know? So, it's a way of life that we have to change. And the most important medication, I was told, is not the best chemo drug. It's not the best radiotherapy treatment. Okay, it's really up here, all right? How you look at it positively and move forward. It's a journey that there's no need for you to walk alone. Whether you are heart, you are stroke, you are a cancer survivor. Okay? There are support groups around. Look around, ask around. Okay? And in fact, our support group now, we extend it to beyond just nose cancer, because we believe that any cancer survivors will share the same journey. In fact, beyond cancer, as I said earlier. All right. So we welcome any survivors to join us. Okay, this is my support group, very quickly. Okay, started by Dr. Lee here, back in 08. Then Peter Tang, our founding father, and Dr. Chu started in 09 in NUH. I was treated in NUH in 2002, okay? But I didn't know about the support group until 2010. Okay? That's our mission statement. Right? I took over from Peter in May this year. Okay, so okay, we have a coming party on the 15th November. So survivors and families, if you are free, drop by and join us. So these are the committee member and their spouse. And some of these, like Wendy, these are all the backstage heroes and heroines supporting us. Okay? Then we have some of our heroes and heroines here. Like Eunice is here, Fauzi, Celine, Rethink, and Jesse. Okay, in our support group has this sharing every month, alternate between Tan Tock Seng and NUH, alright? So Tan Tock Seng sharing is at Care Connect here, and then NUHS sharing is at the Tower Block at Level 10. Okay, this is my last slide. Okay, this is just a message from my daughter. She was P6 then. P6, yeah, I think so. P6 then. And then I brought her to this live party, and then she saw everything, she just commented, and then she wrote this. Okay, that's the end of my slide. So really, this journey is not about me walking alone. It's we all can do it together, right? And we have to do it together. So I really hope that we can reach out to people who are still, you know, it's not easy, of course. There are people who just keep to themselves, stay in their cave. We want the people to step up, okay? If you don't want to step up, at least make the phone call. My number is available, right? Call us, call me, call my community member. We'll reach out to you. Right, it's important to reach out because that is where, you know, I was very motivated when I saw people who survived for 20, 30 years and still running the marathon. You know, it's so motivating, so powerful. That's why it actually made me to join the support group and myself to be the committee. And I want to influence other people as well with my committee member. All right. So I hope all of you here, a ping of health, and please help us to spread the message. Okay? Thanks for being here today. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Cheow.